I am Dr. Pratap Naikwade. Welcome you all for online 1 week interdisciplinary certificate course in basics of organic farming conducted by IQSC and Department of Botany, Atle Saprepitre College, Devruk.
Hello dear friends. In this video, we will explore major organic products exported from India, major crops in organic farming, challenges of organic farming in India, strategies to promote organic farming, as well as we will discuss some government schemes promoting organic farming that may be your point of interest. Friends, organic agriculture is natural in Indian context. It is not just a philosophy, but is also a mean to stabilize our food products through maintenance of soil health and avoiding the use of hazardous chemicals. In India, only 30% of total cultivable area is covered with chemical fertilizer, where irrigation facilities are available, and in the remaining 70% of arable land, which is mainly rain-fed, negligible amount of chemical fertilizers are used. Farmers in these areas often use organic manures as sources of nutrients are readily available either in their own farm or in their locality. But unfortunately, they don't have knowledge about certification process of organic food. In this course, we are also providing information about certification process of organic food later on. The northeastern hills of India provides considerable opportunity, 80 million hectares for organic farming due to least utilization of chemical inputs, which can be exploited for organic production. India is home to 30% of total organic producers in the world. India ranked first in terms of number of organic producers as well as export of organic food in the world among over 170 countries. India is at 9th rank in terms of area under organic agriculture. This graph shows major organic products exported in India. India produced around 1.35 million metric ton of certified organic products, which include all varieties of food products. The production is not limited to the edible sector, but also produces organic cotton fiber, functional food products, etc. The major organic products exported from India are tea, rice, fruit and vegetables, cotton, wheat, spices, coffee, cashew nut, pulses, herbal products, as well as oilseed. This table compares India as well as other countries regarding the promotion of organic farming. The organic action plan in India need location specific, and it must be focused on the action plans. In India, government is provided in terms of subsidies or incentives to the organic farmers. Occasional as well as a training program is given to the interested people. However, the global awareness about organic farming in Indian farmers, it is very low as compared to the other countries like China, USA, Australia, France, as well as Germany. This is the table which shows state-wise farm area under organic certification. So these are the states and these are the organic area in hectares. So when we compare Madhya Pradesh, it is at the first rank, followed by Rajasthan, whereas Maharashtra have only 85,536 organic hectare area under certification. It shows that there are so many other states which can maximize their area under organic certification. The major crops grown under organic farming varies as we move from one state to another state. In Andhra Pradesh, the major crops grown are cotton, maize, pulses, oilseed, fruits and vegetables. Maximum variety of the crops grown can be seen in Sikkim, which is organic state. So here the major crops are maize, rice, buckwheat, finger millet, vegetables, spices as well as herbs. In Maharashtra, the crops are cotton, rice, wheat, pulses, oilseeds, spices. Now we will discuss some of the challenges of organic farming in India. The first challenge, it is the need of resources. Livestock resources play important role in strengthening agricultural properties for large mass in India. With the advent of technology, the livestock population in our country has declined sharply. Also, large part of rural population in our country is poor and depends on animal manure for the domestic fuel. This further constrains the availability of annual manure for the agricultural use. Lack of sufficient stock of vermicompost and biofertilizer in the local market is also another constraint which is associated with availability of appropriate amount of biopesticides as well as other components of organic farming. In India, most of the crop residue is removed from the field for the purpose of fodder as well as the fuel, and therefore it is not used for the mulching as well as the raw material for the organic manures. Second challenge, it is certification. The time lag of 3 years for the conservation stage often constrains small farmers from adopting organic farming. The certification is essential to authenticate organic produce and to validate the price margin in the market. Lack of knowledge and access to certification discourage the small farmers to go for organic farming. Another thing, it is conditions for certification are strict. Third challenge is social acceptance. The majority of small farmers depend on government incentives, and so therefore the small farmers, they are not accepting to go only for organic farming because its social acceptance is very less. Now we will see strategies to promote organic farming in India. Promoting organic farming through agrotourism, by which urban families are encouraged towards organic farming and farmers also get premium prices. You might have visited some of the agrotourism spots. Second, support must be provided by the professionals in branding organic products to the farmers. Guidance must be provided for retailing packaging as well as labeling to promote organic products. Attractive packaging can be done through the organic waste. High value crop having commercial viability, industrial use and export potential should be considered over the crops, and so therefore guidance must be given regarding the crop selection. Apart from that, some government schemes, they are also promoting organic farming, which we will see one by one. There are many states and private agencies involved in promotion of organic farming in India. These include various ministries and departments of the government at the central as well as the state level. Some of the government schemes are Horticulture Mission for Northeast and Himalayan States, Macro Management of Agriculture, Mission for Integrated Development and Horticulture, National Horticulture Mission, National Mission for Sustainable Agriculture, National Program on Organic Production, National Project on Management of Soil, Health and Fertility, National Project on Organic Farming, Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana. Those participants who are interested in these government schemes can apply for that schemes. For detailed information, you have to search these schemes and get benefit of these schemes. India is providing support to the small farmers to grow organic products. Another very important scheme by the government, it is Paramparagat Krushi Vikas Yojana. It means that the traditional organic farming must be promoted in modern era. Under this scheme, 50 or more farmers are encouraged to form a cluster of 50 acres of land to take up organic farming. 10,000 clusters to be formed, covering 5 lakh acre area in 3 years. In this scheme, every farmer will get rupees 20,000 per acre for production as well as the distribution of produce, and it will create better links to the market and certification of organic produce. These are some of the references used. In next video, we will study nutrient management in organic farming. Thank you.